Good evening. I'm Dr. Hayes Bunch. I'm the director of bands here at Young Harris College, and we welcome you to the concert band's final concert of the academic year, and we're glad you're here to let us share with you. The piece you just heard was Prelude to Revelry by Gordon Jacob, and Jacob studied compositional theory and conducting at the Royal College of Music with Charles William Stanford, Adrian Bolt, and Ralph Vaughan Williams, and he joined the RCM staff in 1924 and remained there until his retirement in 1966. At the time of his death in 1984, he had written over 700 works, and his numerous offerings for wind band, including Old Wine and New Bottles, Music for a Festival, Original Suite, and William Byrd Suite, followed the precedent set by Gustav Holst, who you hear at the end of the program tonight, and former teacher Ray Vaughan Williams. And so this trio of English composers really formed the cornerstone of the wind band repertoire in the early part of the 20th century. Prelude to Reverie, the tune that you heard tonight, is based on two traditional British drinking songs, Little Brown Jug and Come Landlord Fill the Flowing Bowl. The material was originally used as incidental music for a radio comedy and was scored later for brass band, and in the late 40s, Dr. Jacob rescored the piece for symphonic wind band. Next on the program, Houseplants in Terracotta Pots. Dr. Roy B. Magnuson received a BM in Theory and Composition from Illinois State University, a Master's in Composition from Ithaca College in Ithaca, New York, and his DMA in Composition from the University of Illinois. He has also studied privately with David Maslenka, Jennifer Higdon, Stephen Stuckey, Carol Husa, and Joan Tower. Dr. Magnuson has composed music for a variety of mediums: orchestra, wind ensemble, electroacoustic, vocalist, chamber ensembles, etc., and his works have been performed throughout the United States. He's currently an instructional assistant faculty member at Illinois State, where he teaches freshman and sophomore theory and coordinates the freshman theory curriculum. The composer writes the following about houseplants and terracotta pots. The plants we fill our houses with are beautiful in their simplicity and simply beautiful in their complexity. This music comes from my sincere desire to create art that, like houseplants, does a thing and does it well. A simple statement of something simply thought. Please enjoy Houseplants in Terracotta Pots by Dr. Roy D. Magnuson. Thank you. Thank you all so much. Our next piece on the program, Merry Music, by Frigyes Hidas, Hungarian composer Frigyes Hidas. He studied composition at the Budapest Academy of Music. He composed in a musical language that was always easily approachable, but never undemanding, if you will, and with great professionalism always. In the rhythms of his instrumental works, as you will hear a little tonight, you hear the inspiration of jazz, and it's often felt in some of his instrumental output. He composed in every genre, opera, ballet, oratorio. He has a mass, two requiems, a symphony, numerous concerti, chamber and solo pieces, film music, and above all, chamber music for brass instruments and works for wind ensemble and concert band. Hidas's Merry Music is a pleasant little work in an ABA structure. Hidas justifies the title by incorporating bouncy Hungarian dance and folk song rhythms with the late romanticism of Tchaikovsky. With his careful scoring technique, including sparse use of percussion, the composer creates a really light kind of feeling, even when played by, you know, a large instrumental ensemble. So we hope you enjoy Merry Music by Frigyes Hidas.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. Our next piece on the program, On Parade. Amanda Aldridge was the third child of African-American Shakespearean actor Ira Frederick Aldridge and his second wife, the Swedish Amanda Brandt. Aldridge studied voice and harmony and counterpoint at the Royal College of Music in London. After completing her studies, Aldridge worked as a concert singer, piano accompanist, and voice teacher. A throat condition ended her concert appearances, and she turned to teaching and published about 30 songs between the years 1907 and 1925 in a romantic sort of parlor style, as well as instrumental music in other styles. She composed love songs, suites, sambas, light orchestral pieces, working in a popular style that was infused with multiple genres. On Parade is an English quickstep march featuring a typical first and second string, a trio, and an unusual secondary trio area that modulates the piece to a third tonal area. So please enjoy Amanda Aldridge's On Parade. Graduated from Capitol High School at the top of her class and was enrolled at the New England Conservatory of Music with a major in piano and organ. At the conservatory, she was able to study composition and counterpoint, and she graduated in 1906 with honors and both an artist diploma in organ and a teaching certificate. In 1932, both Price submitted compositions for the Wanamaker Foundation Awards, and through this, won first prize with her symphony in E minor. And in fact, the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Frederick Stock, premiered the symphony on June 15, 1933, making Price's piece the first composition by an African-American woman to be played by a major orchestra. In 2009, a substantial collection of her works and papers were found in an abandoned house on the outskirts of St. Anne, Illinois, and these consisted of dozens of her scores, including her two violin concertos and her fourth symphony. The Old Boatman is one of those works. And this short little melodic work was composed for piano as a benefit of her developing piano students. And upon hearing it, Dana Paulperna found it very reminiscent of Edvard Grieg, specifically his lyric pieces and the 19 Norwegian folk tunes, Opus 66. Author Alex Ross stated in The New Yorker in February of 2018, not only did Price fail to enter the canon, a large quantity of her music came perilously close to obliteration. That rundown house in St. Anne is a potent symbol of how a country can forget its cultural history. We hope you enjoy The Old Boatman by Florence Price.
Thank you.
Thank you all so very much. Our last piece on the program is rather a staple in the wind band repertoire, the second suite in F for military band from 1911, Gustav Holst. And this English composer's compositions for wind band, although only a small portion of his total output, have made him a cornerstone of the genre, and I mentioned that earlier in reference to Gordon Jacobs' work. The second suite consists of four movements, all based on specific English folk songs. The march of the second suite begins, the first movement begins with a simple five-note motif between the low and high instruments of the band, as you'll hear. The folk tune Glorishears and Swansea Town and Cloudy Banks are heard. The second movement, Song Without Words, here Holst places the fourth folk song, I'll Love My Love, in a very stark, heart-wrenching contrast to the first movement. Movement three, again, Holst contrasts the slow second movement to the rather upbeat third movement, which features the folk song, A Blacksmith Courted Me. The brass section plays in a pointillistic style, and the band is accompanied with the sound of a blacksmith tempering metal with an anvil called for in the score. And movement four, the Fantasia on the Dargison. This movement is not based on any folk songs, but rather has two tunes from Playford's Dancing Master of 1651. The finale of the suite opens with an alto saxophone solo based on the folk tune Dargison, a 16th century English dance tune included in the first edition of the Dancing Master. The final folk tune, Greensleeves, is cleverly woven into the Fantasia by the use of hemiola, or a two against three kind of sort of rhythmic pattern, with the Dargison being in two and Greensleeves being in three. And finally, a tuba and a piccolo flute have a little duet to close the movement. Holst later rewrote and rescored this movement, the final movement for string orchestra, as the final movement of his St. Paul's suite from 1912, which he wrote for his music students at St. Paul's Girls' School. We hope you enjoy Gustav Holst's second suite in F for military band. We appreciate your attendance tonight and your support of the bands at Young-Harris College, the music department at Young-Harris College, and the Division of Fine Arts, and we hope you will join us for some of our final events as we close out the spring semester. So thank you very much once again. Thank you. Thank you all so much. Have a lovely evening.